Hi, my name is Felipe Anaya, and I'm the undergraduate research librarian. In this video, you're going to learn how to access many of the business resources to help you with your upcoming assignments. In addition, you'll learn how to contact me for any help, as well as learn how to cite these various sources of information in your papers using the APA citation style. So we're going to jump over to looking at how to access these resources by starting off on the library homepage. On the library homepage, you'll find how to contact us and schedule an appointment. And up here at the top, you're going to click on Research Guides to get access to our business resources. I'm going to click on Research Guides. And these are guides that are created by subject areas. So they have a bunch of resources if you're looking at biology or health. I'm going to click on Business. And then Business once again. On this page is where you're going to find my contact information. You'll have my email, and you can also schedule a consultation. So after this video, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'm more than happy to help you. In addition, I'm also the librarian you can contact if you have any questions related to any of your other classes. I'm here to support you. So I'm going to start off by looking for articles. And in your upcoming assignments, one of the things you might need to do is find some company information. So we're going to go over here to Business Source Ultimate. We also have ABI Inform Trade and Industry. It's an alternative. It's kind of like Netflix and Hulu, where you're searching for a video to watch. And sometimes you'll start off with Netflix, and sometimes you'll find what you want in Hulu. So we'll open up Business Source Ultimate. And I'm going to start off by entering in the name of a company in the search box. We'll put in General Motors and then click on Search. Here is our list of results. You'll see that we have quite a few, 40,000. So there are different ways to refine your results on the left-hand side of the screen. You can refine by date range. For example, I might type in 2020, so I get the last couple years of articles. Then as you're going down here, you'll see we have articles. Sometimes you'll have reports. And then we also get the SWOT analysis. SWOT analysis, it stands for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. And it's a good way to getting an understanding of the evaluation and analysis for a company and how well they're doing. I'm going to click on the top article. The first thing that you'll see is information about the article as well as the abstract. The abstract is a great summary to read first before you actually download the article to see if it's something that's going to fit your needs. When you already download the article, it's here on the left-hand side as the PDF full text. And then on the right-hand side are a series of tools. You can email the article to yourself for later, and you can also click on Cite. So if you want to make sure that you're always citing your sources, in this class, you're going to use APA, which is typical of business. And so you can copy this citation, add it to your list of references. Now, let's say you want to find information on a topic. Say you're writing a discussion post. So I'm going to look up franchise as well as considerations. And we'll click on search. Sometimes when you're doing search, you're going to find that you're going to have to scroll down through a longer list of results to find what you need. Because I was doing this search earlier today, I found like the sixth option, 10 things to consider before buying a franchise, seem to fit better in terms of what I'm looking for. And then I can once again click on the article and access the PDF. So that's how you use Business Source Ultimate to find articles. Now, if you're looking for additional company information, you can click on this tab here. And then we can look at Business Market Research Collection, which is going to provide us a profile of various companies. So when I click on this link, I'm going to once again enter the name of my company, which is typically when you're doing company research, all you need to do is enter the name of your company to find some information. Here are my list of results. It's going to be near the top. And so we have General Motors Company. We click on the link, and we're going to get a report from a company called Hoovers. So as we scroll down on this, looking at the table of contents, we get some key information. information about the people who work at the company, some financials, and who are the competitors. So it's a great start to get a good some background information on your company. And then once you get that background information, if you want to find some additional statistics about how well the company is doing, we can look at Statista. I'm going to click on Statista. And once again, search for my company. You'll see here we have a number of results. I'm going to click on the second one that says statistics and facts about General Motors. Whenever you click on the blue icon ones, you're just going to get a quick summary of information, but the red ones are going to give you a bit more data. So as we begin to look through this list, we have an overview, more information about their financials, their competitors, and special focus on the US market. Let's say, for example, we want to look at their revenue for the last few years. When I click on that link, here you can see that we have the revenue for General Motors over the years. You can download this information. And then if you're going to be using this information in a report, you can also cite it using the citation formats where you click on View Options. And here you'll have the APA citation. Statista is a really great tool for finding information about companies, but also anytime you're thinking about finding any type of statistic. If I go to the homepage, you'll see some of the topics it covers is like fast fashion in Europe, Nike, social media usage. So feel free to explore Statista for some of your other classes. Now I mentioned that some of the resources have quick tools for learning how to cite your sources. On this research guide, we also have this citing using APA 7th edition tab, and it's going to guide you into how to cite your various sources of information. And then for some of the business resources, APA doesn't do a good job in explaining how to cite them. And so what we did, it was put together a guide that shows you how to cite various sources using APA type of format for things like the census, a company website, or something like Passport. These are some other databases that you might use in some of your future classes. And then once again, if you have trouble with citing any of your resources, feel free to contact me. Once again, my email is here on the front page, as well as schedule a consultation. So I hope you've got a quick introduction to learning how to find some of our business resources to help you with your upcoming assignments. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me.